Hello, so welcome to another reading vlog. I should probably be asleep, but I'm going to start this reading vlog instead of getting enough sleep. It's already like the 22nd of the month, and I've spent most of the month reading Wheel of Time, the first book, Eye of the World. So we've only got like a week left in the month, and I still want to read both these books on my TBR. I don't know if it's going to be possible, but we're going to try, and I'm going to start with this one. I actually last night read the first chapter of it, but not more than that. Basically, the first chapter was just all these school kids driving through windy mountain roads in New Zealand, and then at the end of that first chapter, there's a crash. And I'm pretty sure that somehow the teenagers on the bus are going to be left without adults. And it's going to get really scary because this is supposed to be a horror novel. I think maybe like a YA horror. But it's by a New Zealand Maori author, and I'm excited to read it. So that's going to be my first read. That's a lie. I actually am also reading another ebook on my phone. It's very short though, so I was hoping I would finish it tonight, but it's already bedtime, so I don't know, maybe. It's very short, and I'm already like 25% in. So, what's it actually called? Forest of Memory by Mary Robinette Kowal. So it's set in a world in the future where people have like these artificial intelligence assistants that record all their memories for them and provide them with information, and also like everything you do is being recorded and tracked, and so you don't really have to rely on your real memory to remember things. And also a lot of what you do can be easily shared with other people. But this woman is an authenticities dealer, so she goes and finds real objects and provides them to collectors. So in this world as well, they can print almost anything they want, but certain people like to collect like real objects from the past, not just fakes. So she goes around finding those kinds of objects. She also sells captures, so she'll go and like have some kind of unique experience and record it and then sell that to people. However, the story that we're reading is something she's writing on this typewriter that she found that someone has bought off her, and they're also wanting the story of what happened after she bought this typewriter, and she has sort of fallen into this situation where her memories were not being recorded for a time, and so she's having to rely on her real memory to tell you the story about what happened during the time. And she's talking about how difficult it is to remember things. It's really interesting the way it's written, because she's talking about like, I think this happened all the time, whereas when she's talking about things she's recorded, she's able to tell you like exactly what happened, and it's quite an interesting contrast. But right in the bit I'm in, she's in a scary situation, so I'm going to try and finish that now, and then I'll be able to tell you what I think about it as well. Actually, I am reading one other thing, and that is Kafka on the Shore by Haruki Murakami. So I'm listening to this on audiobook. It's a really weird story. Not a surprise, because Haruki Murakami always writes weird stories. The only other thing I've read by him is the Wind-Up Bird Chronicles, but there are some interesting connections, which I'm quite enjoying. So the main story on Kafka on the Shore is about this 15-year-old boy who's run away from home, and he's kind of having some weird experiences living in a library at the moment. To be honest, that part of the story is not my favorite. He's a 15-year-old boy, and it's written, you know, with all that classic 15-year-old boys obsessed with girls kind of stuff, which I don't enjoy reading, even if it's realistic. There's also this weird bit in kind of the alternate story where this woman was talking about her period, and that was also like, no thank you. So Haruki Murakami does sometimes have some weird kind of sexual stuff in there, which I'm not a fan of, but I do like the real weird stuff. So I don't care too much yet about this 15-year-old boy who's run away, but there's also this other storyline, and I don't know how it connects yet, but there were a bunch of children who fell unconscious, and it's kind of all these interviews that were done as part of the investigation of what had happened to them. And one of these children has grown up into this man, and he is not very smart, and he also has the ability to talk to cats. And so what he does is he uses that to go and search out missing cats, and he will help find them by talking to other cats in order to track these cats down, these missing cats. Now, in the Wind-Up Bird Chronicles, which is the other book I read by Haruki Murakami, it's all about this man trying to find his lost cat. And I'm really interested to see how many connections there might be there. It's just really interesting that it's another story about finding lost cats. And I really like the cats as well. Like, he's talked to several cats so far, and they've all been really different, but I've loved all of them and just the way he interacts with these cats. So I'm really interested to see what will happen with those two storylines, how they're gonna interact, and just what's gonna happen with this man who can talk to cats, and he's trying to track down this one particular cat, but it looks like something bad has happened to that cat. I'm really enjoying it. I think I'm about 25% of the way through, so I've still got a bit to go in there as well, because that's quite a long audiobook. Anyway, if I'm gonna read Forest of Memory tonight, I really need to go to bed and do that, so I'll see you tomorrow. Hello, so I made it to the weekend, thank goodness, and I thought I'd give you a quick update on my reading before I head out with Jace to enjoy what I think looks like it's gonna be a pretty sunny day now that the fog has cleared, and I really need a nice sunny relaxing day. But reading wise, so I finished a couple of things. No, I finished one thing. I finished Forest of Memory by Mary Robinette Kowal. In the end, I was a little bit disappointed in the ending, which is often the case with short stories because you want to know more than it's giving you. So I really liked the world and the technology and the way it was being explored, but the thing that was happening with her when she was kind of out of range of her virtual assistant that would record her memories, we didn't really find out enough about what was happening there. And maybe I missed some clues, but the ending just felt very incomplete to me, and I was annoyed that there wasn't more, because it was a really interesting world and a really interesting setup. And I really liked the writing style and the way the story was being told. And this is why I like longer books. Anyway, I did enjoy it. I enjoyed the journey, just the ending. I was like, why is that the ending? The other things that I have been reading, so I started reading a bit more of Flight of the Fantail, but honestly, I fell asleep super quick again. So I'm only on chapter 8, because the chapters are really short, but only page 27. Basically, after this school bus has crashed, we're following different teenagers as they wake up and, or like as they survive the crash, and they're all kind of in different places, although some of them have met up. One of them has seen another girl stealing things from the dead bodies of the other students, and I'm pretty sure there's another girl where there are two of her, so I expect one of them is not really her. So it is interesting, and I really need to find some more time to read this, but it'll have to be after I enjoy the sunshine. The other thing I have been doing is listening to the audiobook of Kafka on the Shore, and I don't know how I feel about this now. I was really enjoying the conversations with the cats, and there were some reveals that really made me laugh, and I was really enjoying it. And then we got into this section of like what the fuck kind of stuff. We had to sit through a whole bunch of cats being killed and this really weird Johnny Walker character, which, what was the point of that? I just feel like in the Wind Up Bird Chronicle, I felt like even though there were lots of weird things going on and lots of seemingly disconnected stories, I could see how a common theme was pulling them all together, and they were still interesting. There were a few bits that I didn't enjoy, but mostly it felt fairly cohesive despite the weird way that Haruki Murakami writes. But this one, I'm probably, how far through am I? I must be nearly 50% of the way through, right? Oh, come on, phone, wake up. It's not that hard. I did it. So I'm 44% of the way through, and I don't feel like I know what the theme of the story is. Oh, and just now when I was doing some house cleaning, I was listening to a bit more of it, and it was talking about Oedipus, like this boy who's run away kind of has had this Oedipus type prophecy put on him, which is kind of interesting, but also like, oh no. Is he gonna sleep with his mother and his sister? Is he? It's one thing to have that in like Greek plays back in the day, but it's a whole nother thing to have that in a modern story. But we'll see how he handles it, I guess. I guess I'll continue it, but again, I'm gonna go enjoy the sunshine first, and then we'll work out what we're doing with everything else. just going to walk along the path with us. Don't go back on the road. Go on. That's better. That's where you belong. Oh, you're very nice, aren't you? Huh? No.
What can you see up there?
Hmm? What do you think of us? We're annoying you. Sorry about that. Humans are just annoying, that's what we do best.
It looks like a fish.
Oh my goodness, that was very rude.
Oh dear.
That was very rude. He's going to attack us and I'm going to cry. Are you going to go back on the road? Are you an idiot?
So it ended up being just like a really nice and relaxing weekend and I was feeling really good. And then it just took one day of work for me to feel stressed again, so that's very annoying. I was hoping that today I could do like a short day and then make up the hours later in the week when I had to go in the office. But actually, I had to do lots of extra hours today and I'm now gonna have to go into work tomorrow as well, but I'm hoping I can finish early. I'm hoping, but will it happen? I don't really know. There's a lot going on at work at the moment, which is annoying because really, all I wanna do is read my books. Stupid work. Anyway, I am now up to page 115 of The Flight of the Fantail, and I'm enjoying it. Like, it's nothing revolutionary. We've just got all these teens trying to survive as it started to rain and there's flooding and some of them are injured. There's definitely some weird things going on. I think I said before that there was a girl in two places. More, there's been a couple of times when characters have seen people who we're pretty sure we know are dead. Pretty sure, but they could be alive. I'm not sure. But it's just written in a really super fast-paced kind of style. Every chapter is only a few pages long and I'm just really enjoying it. So, since I spent all day at my desk being stressed, I haven't gotten any steps, so I'm gonna spend like the next hour walking around my house with my book to try and get some steps because I can't go out because it's pouring with rain. Do I sound stressed? I feel stressed. Anyway, the other thing that I've been reading is Kafka on the Shore, so I'm up to 58%. What happened since I last talked to you? Our main character has been falling in love with a ghost, and I feel like somewhere in there must be the theme of the story, but I haven't quite managed to identify it. I do think that part, it's kind of all about love and grief. I feel like some people might like that, but I'm a bit bored by it, and I find like the romance kind of icky. As well, in our other story with the man who can talk to cats, so he's kind of traveling around at the moment. There was one bit where he ran into Colonel Sanders. Was it him who ran into Colonel Sanders or the guy he's traveling with? I think the guy he's traveling with, but honestly, we've had Johnny Walker and now we've got Colonel Sanders. Just stop it. It's ridiculous. And we haven't had any more cats, and so, I don't know, now we're trying to find some kind of magical stone. It's very strange and it's all over the place and I don't know if I like it. I definitely don't think I'm enjoying it as much as I enjoyed The Wind-Up Bird Chronicle. But since I'm now going into the office multiple times this week, I should definitely be able to finish that this week. I was actually just looking at my TBR before and there were several other audiobooks that I wanted to read this month. But this month ends on Saturday, so I guess we'll see how that works out. But right now, I'm going to read some more of this. Hello, so it's Sunday night now. I don't even know when I last updated this vlog. I just have been struggling this week, this month, this year, but I'm still hopeful that things are gonna get less chaotic soon, but we'll see what happens, I guess. But I thought I would give you guys an update. Firstly, like representative of how much of a mess I've been, I was finishing off Kafka on the Shore and I had 10 minutes to go, but I got to work and I thought that's fine, I'll finish it after work, not forgetting that it was going to return itself to the library. And so I was in a meeting when I got a notification saying like, your audiobook has been returned and there's a 3-week hold list. So I don't know, I've put a new hold on it, but to be honest,
I didn't really enjoy it. There were some bits I really loved with the talking cats, and there were definitely some lines that were really funny and some that were really insightful, but there was also just a lot of mucking around and also like just stuff that was gross or unnecessary. Like, the main character rapes someone. It's in a dream, but, like, the whole story is kind of about how reality is something we create in our minds anyway, and so then it's questioning what's the difference between dreams and imagination and reality. But I just don't feel like I got much from that theme. It didn't really mean anything to me. And overall, it was disappointing, and I can't really imagine the last 10 minutes doing anything that would change my opinion of it. So that's a shame, because I was really hoping I would like it, because I really liked The Wind-Up Bird Chronicle by Haruki Murakami. So I think I'll have to read at least one more Murakami book to decide whether he is a yes or a no for me. I think Kafka on the Shore is probably one of his earlier books, so maybe he got less ugh and more meaningful with his writing. Maybe, I guess. What else? Oh, as well, I've been reading this, Flight of the Fantail, and honestly, I've got like, I think only like a few, honestly, I think I've only got like 6 pages to go or something. But the other night, I was reading it and I was so tired that I couldn't even make it through 6 pages, so I stopped. But I am really enjoying it, and I'm excited to see how it's going to end. I can't even tell you about what's happening, because it's so not what I expected from this book that like, it would definitely be spoilers to talk about it, but I'm really enjoying how it's weaving in Maori mythology and just like the really New Zealand tone of things. There's lots of just casual mentions of like New Zealand birds, and I don't know, it's just something about the way the characters talk that it feels more genuine, because it's like people that I would actually talk. And it's kind of, the story's a little bit ridiculous. It's not taking itself too seriously, and I really like that. Some of the humor in this is just perfect, and maybe it's just Kiwi humor, but I'm really enjoying it. So I'm gonna try and finish this tonight. However, as well, I've accidentally fallen into binging Loki. My friend managed to get me access to it, so I thought I would watch like maybe an episode or two, and I just finished episode 5, and at this point I may as well watch the last episode and see what happens. So I guess I'm gonna do that now, because you guys know I really love time travel, and Loki is all like this time travel multiverse stuff going on, and I just love Sylvie so much, and Loki is probably my most favorite Marvel character. So even though I actually haven't watched a lot of the Marvel films, I watched like the Legends series, which kind of just updates you, so I don't have to watch all the boring Captain America, Iron Man stuff that I honestly don't care about. I can just watch Loki. So I'm gonna go and finish that, and then I'll let you know when I've finished more things. Hopefully, it won't take me in a week to come back and update you this time. So honestly, it's another couple of days later, but I wanted to give you a final update and finish off this vlog. So I finally read the final like 6 pages of this book, and things came together very quickly at the end. I almost feel like there could still be a sequel to this. Like, the ending was not completely like, everyone's happy. Our main characters aren't necessarily in a safe place yet. But I also don't know that there's much more to the story to tell, but there could be more story, so that's open. I'm pretty sure there isn't going to be a sequel to this, but like, I wouldn't be against it. There were some cool ideas in here that weren't completely explored, and I think it's fine for the story that this was. You wouldn't want to go into all those things, but there's a lot of potential with some of the things that happened. Especially around kind of the Maori mythology that was incorporated, and it's really hard to talk about without spoiling this, but I really enjoyed this. I just thought it was a lot of fun. It went in some really weird directions, but there were some cool ideas, and the teenage characters, like, they were probably teenage angsty, but it wasn't like all romance rubbish that I don't care about, so I really enjoyed it. As well, I finished watching Loki. Honestly, I ended up binging the whole series in one day, which was entirely not planned, but I kind of had a suspicion I would really love it, and I did. All the twisty time stuff was cool. Sylvie is my absolute favorite, and I'm really interested to see what they're going to do with all the time stuff in season 2, which I guess I will now have to wait for. Anyway, I feel like I don't even remember when I started this vlog at this point. I think? No, I don't know. Anyway, do let me know if you have read any of the things that I have read in this vlog, and if you have, what you thought of them. Do you disagree with some of my thoughts? As well, are you interested in reading any books? I'm pretty sure most people wouldn't have read this, but if you don't mind YA horrors, I would recommend it. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you are doing well, and I will see you next time.